Airtable recently released a brand new interface page type. This one is called Overview. It allows us to put together a summary page for anybody who we're introducing as a new user to an existing Airtable interface. If you're ready to learn more about the Overview interface page, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools, unlocking their full power. And in this video, as I said, we're going to be taking a look at the new Airtable interface page called Overview. But before we get to that, I first want to invite you to join me for some free Airtable training. I've put together this Airtable crash course so that if you're new to Airtable or if you want to make sure that you're just not missing something about its key features, you can grab that training for free at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. I'll be sure to include a link wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and take a look at this brand new overview interface designer page. Now, first, I should say that I'm inside an actual interface that we use all the time. Actually, this is what we use for our content planning. We plan our different content for this YouTube channel all inside of this Airtable interface. Now, if you're still a little new to Airtable, let me maybe rewind and give us a little bit of context here. There are three key components of any Airtable solution. They consist of the data. This is where we store the information. We build the proper data schema. We interconnect all these tables and we basically house all of our information that we need for our process. Then the second component is automations. Automations is where we do all the magic in the background, automating different processes using what's called if this, then that logic, meaning if this happens, then do that thing. So we build all of this inside of our Airtable automations. That's the second key component to Airtable. The third is how we share that information. And we have a lot of control over how we share it. This is called interfaces. Now, if you're brand new to interfaces, first thing you need to know is that you can have multiple interfaces on the same database, and you can have multiple interface pages inside of an interface. So an interface, you can think of as kind of like a folder of a bunch of pages. And inside of that, each page has its own unique way of showing data and its own permissions. You know, how are we going to view it? What can you see? What can you edit? All of that has to do with each page. So you have full control over that. Now, when you share an interface, you're sharing it at the interface level. So on my screen right here, again, this is live data. This is called the content planning interface. And you'll see that we have two different pages here. We have the content by publication date, and this is a calendar right here. And then we have our partners. If we click into our partners, you'll see all the different partners that we work with inside of our channel, all the different software that is out there that we love and that we help you to do more with. So all of these different things are here. We have all of our different referral links, all the different brand assets like colors and all of this. It all lives off of the same data. Now, again, these two different pages live in the interface called content planning. So maybe when we onboard new people to this interface, we want to have some sort of overview. That, my friends, is exactly why we are going to love this new interface page. Let's go ahead and create it. So if you're starting from scratch, as I am, you're gonna say add a new page. So I wanna add a page to the content planning interface. Alternatively, I can hit this page up here and also add a page here. So either way is fine. It's gonna bring it in and you'll see that you have the brand new option right here of overview. Now, quick tip for you. A lot of times people watch our videos that are 6 months, 12 months old, and these tools are constantly evolving. Constantly new features, new types of views are coming out all the time. So a key tip is if you can't replicate what I'm doing here in the video because you're watching this a year in the future, things might change. Software is always evolving. Check out the blank option down here, assuming it still exists. This blank option allows us to add individual elements to an interface. It's really, really easy to customize if you have some general direction. Now for us, I don't want to have to go piece by piece by piece. So I'm just gonna start with overview. Plus that's the point of this whole video anyway. So this overview, as you see when we highlight over it, it highlights important pages and resources. So let's go ahead and add it and finish it up. And you'll see now we have a third page down here. Now, given that this is an overview, I am going to drag it up to the top because I want it to be the first thing that everyone sees when they access the interface. So let's take a look. We have the ability to add a cover image here. Nice. The ability to add a logo. If you're familiar with Airtable already, this looks a lot like a form. This is kind of the same layout that Airtable forms have, with a cover image up here, and then a logo beneath, and then a header, and then some subtext. So I'm gonna say, I don't mind saying overview, but let's actually change this to say content planning overview, because that is what this interface is. And here we can do a little description, learn to navigate the vital parts of this interface. I mean, I'm sure you can do better than that. I'm working on the fly here, folks. Let's go ahead and drop in a brief description. And then the next component that we see is this group right here. So this section, or this group, this bookmark is what it says. This is in here, we have two different bookmarks, the content by publication date, interesting. And then we also have the partners bookmark. So these are the different elements inside of this section. So what we can do is actually bookmark different elements. And by default, this is automatically grabbed the different pages inside of our interface. Remember, we have content by publication and partners. So let's take a look at these different bookmarks and see what happens. If I go to the properties here, we can see that it's saying, hey, it's basically highlighting this interface page. Maybe we want to write a description of what this is. Plan the content for the YouTube channel. Simple enough. And then we're deciding whether we want to open the new interface page in the same tab or in a new tab. Now, the cool thing about this is we are automatically set up to this particular page, right? We don't have to actually map it or anything like that. This automatically was done. Now, presumably, we could add more bookmarks here if we wanted to. Just again, select the entire section here, and you can add more bookmarks if you have different pages that you want to send them to. But I think the core idea here is that we're saying, hey, these are the big different components of this interface. We have two different pages in here besides the overview, and we're going to drive people to them with an understanding of what they are. So this is pretty nice. Again, the second one here is going to partners. You can see that when I highlight this. And of course, I could edit a description, decide if it's opening in a new tab or not. So that's it for the bookmarks. It's going to help us highlight the different pages within this interface. Next, let's head on over to the About section here. So About, it looks like it has a bunch of external links. So maybe these are not necessarily driving us to the different pages of the interface. Maybe they have more to do with SOPs or something to do with external links or like other portals that people have to log into. Like there could be a number of different things associated with this. But in general, it's going to have to do with the work that we are doing in this interface. So for example, maybe we wanted to put our different partner links here. I could come in and say, these are links for all the different partners that we have so that we can go and check out the different software. This way, as new people come in to use the interface in general, as we onboard new team members, they're taken to this overview and they can kind of figure out all the different resources. The idea is that we're consolidating all the resources in one place. So if we select one of these links, you'll see that we can change the title. So maybe I just want to call this Airtable. And sure enough, it's going to default to airtable.com, which is perfect. That's exactly what I want. And in this case, I will allow people to open in a new tab. You can see that when I change the title, it's changing it down here. And if I need to select this overall section, right, I'm then able to delete some of these links or add new links, right? So I could add other different partners, I could add other resources, whatever I'm trying to do to guide my team to better use this tool that I'm building. Now down here, we've got other resources. Now, how is this separate? Good question. I'm not really sure how this is, in this case, different from the About section. It has the same components, the same layout, the same elements. So we can adjust the title, right? That's the other resources here. We can also adjust the links inside. If we need to, we can click here and duplicate or delete. We can go into the properties of each of these and see where they go. So right now, there's a couple of default things here, Airtable Help Center and Airtable Templates. Both great resources, by the way, if you're needing help in Airtable. Definitely want to promote those. But of course, I think we're going to overwrite this when we build our own thing. So maybe I want to send people to our website and we can just do that. We could say Gap website and I've got it hotkeyed. There it is. And so just like that, I've been able to add that here. Now, let's assume I'm done. I've already set up all the different resources. Of course, I do want to actually put a cover image in here, so let's find one real quick. And let's drop a logo in as well. All right, so we're all set up with some images. I would probably spend a little bit more time making sure that they fit the space better than this, but this is an example so that you can get the idea. So once we're good here, we're gonna publish, we're gonna send those changes, and now we're in the live instance of the interface. So you can see our big banner here. As I mentioned, this is poorly sized, so I would definitely resize. We added our logo, we have the content planning overview. Now, we could navigate over here and go to the content by publication date or the partners, but I also have these fancy little buttons right here, and I can just highlight those different pages and go right to them. So that's a really nice feature, honestly, where I can just, boom, go right to it. Let's get back here. Let's go back here. And if I want to go down to partners, one click right from the dashboard. I'm thinking that the overview page kind of functions just like a dashboard in that sense, right? It doesn't have any metrics. It's all static data for the most part, but it's helping us put a resource together so that our team knows where to go and they're going to see it once they log in and they can get the questions answered that they have. Now let's check out our external links. If I click this, it'll open up in a new tab, take me right to airtable.com. Perfect. I'm going to flip back. If I click here, I'm going to go right to my website, the Gap Consulting website. It's going to take a minute to load, but same idea here. So we've got everything working all within just a little bit of setup. Like, this is a pretty cool interface page at a high level, fairly simple. But I think that the amount of time that you're going to save by consolidating all of your resources, putting them right here, and now when you share that interface, boom, everybody who gets access to it, this is the first thing they're going to see. Make sure you bump it up to the top. It's basically the summary of what this whole interface does. Make sure this is the first page everyone sees. I think that this is really powerful. I would love to hear your comments in the notes below. And of course, if anything that we did here would be of value to you and you can use our help, feel free to swing by our website. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If you did, give us a thumbs up, a little subscribe, but most importantly, remember to keep on building.